guys, welcome to another Abrant 3's Halo costume making tutorial. We've already covered Pepakura modeling, but we're actually going to go into proper Pepakura assembly. I know a lot of you had questions about, well, I don't understand the numbering system or my model looks like crap, so I'm going to give you some guidelines so your model accurately represents the models that you downloaded. Just to reiterate the materials you're going to need, be sure you get super glue, a liquid super glue, not the gel stuff. I found this 4-pack at Walmart for $1. This stuff works really well. You're going to need to use an X-Acto knife. Scissors don't work very well. And you also can probably buy one of these sharpeners, the handheld sharpener that has a whetstone in the tip, and you can sharpen your blade like that because it will get dull and you don't want to really want to spend a whole lot of money on blades. So you can find this at the knife section or the hunting section in Walmart or Kmart or wherever.
First we'll go over some software problems. Pepakura Designer 3 is the new update, and I'll show you some of the functions that are available in the free version. You'll see that some of the models don't have the numbering system inputted into the models on the printout pages. So what you'll do, you'll need to select a function called Edge ID. To do that, go up to the 2D pattern window, select Show Edge ID, and what that'll do is that'll input the numbering system on the sides and tabs of the model so that you can properly assemble it. Another problem is that you'll notice some of the pieces on the printout pages overlap the page margins after you recalculate the parts to size to your body. To fix that, select the tool called Divide or Connect Faces, and that will allow you to separate the parts at certain seams. Just try to cut them at parts that will allow themselves to be placed onto the paper without going over the margins. And as you'll see, all the pieces now lay into the margins very nicely, and you're able to print out the whole piece without having parts bleed over into other pages. The default line format is a solid line for a cut line, a dotted line for a mountain fold, and a dot dash line for a valley fold. But if you wanted to change them, or if you had a model that was different, go to Setting, Other Settings, and there you'll have the line configurations that are completely customizable.
Next we'll go over cutting. This is the kind of surface that you're going to want to cut on. It's not necessarily wood, it's more like a plywood. Basically any kind of harder surface that does have a little bit of give into it that you can actually make very, very small cut marks into. Something that is going to go all the way through the paper and down into the material just a little ways, so that you're making sure that you go all the way through the paper. So what you're going to try to do when you're cutting is try to stay on the solid line as close as possible. This is a good cut. This is a bad cut. When it comes to folding, what you're going to do is use your X-Acto knife again to score the lines that need to be folded. The key to doing that properly is to press down on your paper hard enough to cut through the first few fibers of the paper, but not hard enough to go all the way through the paper, cutting it completely through. The two kinds of folds that you'll find in the Pepakura models are mountain folds and valley folds. Mountain folds are folded like this. Valley folds are folded like this. This is a good fold. This is a bad fold. The numbering system is probably the most confusing part of Pepakura assembly, but it's actually really simple once you figure out how it works.
There's a number for each side and tab pair for the model. Each tab glues under to the corresponding side. So in other words, tab 87 glues under to side 87. Same with tab 260 to side 260, and so on and so forth. Do this through the entire assembly of the model. When you glue with super glue, the pretty much rule of thumb is less is more. You don't want to put a whole lot of super glue on there because it actually will not dry as quickly. So just a very small ribbon of glue will go a long way so that when you glue your pieces together, it dries pretty much instantly and you'll have a permanent bond for your assembly and you can move on to the next part.
Gluing is probably the most tricky part of assembling a Pepakura model because there's several different ways to do it wrong.
The main two ways to mess it up is that you can actually see some of the tabs sticking out from underneath the side. The second is that the numbers are offset, not centered up with each other. A good glued tab should look like this. The numbers are centered on top of one another, and the side and the tab are completely in line with one another.
So that's pretty much it. Just follow those guidelines and your models will be looking great. Subscribe to my channel and I'll be having some more tutorials coming out soon.